We've based most of our examples on using column charts, but there are a number of other charts. The first one we want to show you is something called a bar chart. So here we're going to highlight the data, go insert, and you'll see over here there's something called a bar chart. When I click on it, you'll see it's basically a column chart put on its side. And there's a whole bunch of options that exist. Let's do a standard one. I click on this. And what you'll see, it creates a chart that stands on its side with the axes along here. Now, in our experience, bar charts often seem to come out in a format that we don't necessarily like. So remember, what you can do is, if that's not looking appropriate, where you actually want the dates to be on one of the axes, I'll come here and say switch row and column. And maybe that's a little better, showing me each month and what's happening. The options available to you with a bar chart are very similar to what's available to you with a column chart. You can work through each of these items and customize any part of it in a similar way to the column charts. So let's right click on the axes, click there. All these items should look familiar. In this case, we'd prefer not to have to read downwards backwards. So we don't want to see March, February, January, but rather January, February, March. So in this case, I'm going to put the categories in reverse order. So you'll see now that's a bit more appropriate. But the axes, I don't want it to appear at the top. I want it to appear at the bottom. And you'll see over here the horizontal axes crosses. I'm going to say please go at the maximum category. And when I click, you'll see I've now got it down here. All the other options are standard, and it's just a case of deciding what you want to change, and it can be changed in a bar chart.